iOS 17.3 is out. It has 5 new features, with one you should turn on right now. There's new collaborative playlists in Apple Music, plus some updates to CarPlay and music sharing, stolen device protection, which is a big one, AirPlay in hotels, and more. First up is collaborative music playlists. The first time you open the Apple Music app after updating to 17.3, you'll see collaboration and playlists right here, and even emoji reactions in those playlists. Now, when you go into a playlist, this could be a new playlist or one you've already created, you'll see a new Collaborate On playlist. Tap that symbol up at the top, then you can invite other people to join. You can choose whether or not you want to approve collaborators. Let's check that on. And now let's start collaborating on this playlist. Now you can send this invite link to someone directly. And once you send it, the recipient will get this kind of invitation, whether it's text or something else. And then you can tap to start collaborating on that playlist. Because I checked approval is needed, you'll see a request to join, even though they have the invite link. You'll get a notification when someone requests access. And if you accidentally declined it like I just did, the person can send the request again, then just tap the green check mark or approve from the notification, and now the second person can add to this playlist. Once someone joins a playlist, they can choose to leave on their end, or you can choose to stop collaborating on your end. You can even choose to display a QR code on your phone screen, and then someone can join this playlist that way. Now someone else can choose to add a song to this playlist. You see there's a little collaborative symbol on the right there. I'll tap on the playlist, add that song, and you'll see that that song got added to the bottom of our shared playlist. You can see the person's picture there, whoever submitted the song, and if you start playing it, there's a new emoji reaction to this song. I can heart it, and then other collaborators can see that emoji on their playlist. All right, I just had a wild idea as I was filming. I'm about to show the QR code on screen. I won't approve collaborators, so if you're watching now, you can pause it, scan the QR code, and then I guess add songs that you want. I might have to shut this down like seconds after you guys actually see this, but let's see how many songs we can get. Remember, your picture and name will show up in the collaborative playlist if you choose to participate. I'm gonna call it the YouTube Mega Playlist. Here's the collaboration link. I'm not going to approve collaborators, so anyone can join. And here's the QR code to do it. And we'll see what happens. I have no idea how many people can join a playlist, but let's test it out. A second improvement is the SharePlay feature if you use CarPlay. Here in CarPlay, if you choose to start sharing, it will have a QR code that shows up on the CarPlay screen. It doesn't have to be on your phone anymore. Someone can scan that, and then they can start playing songs right there to your CarPlay system. You'll also see the name of the person who's currently playing a song, and you can add multiple people or remove them all from the CarPlay interface. All right, number 3, and this is what you should turn on right now, is stolen device protection. This is a feature that Apple has enabled in order to combat the stealing of iPhones and passcodes. Before, there would be a little too much access if someone got your physical phone and your passcode. So now if you go into Face ID and Passcode in your settings, you'll see the normal Face ID settings here. I'll scroll down, and you'll see stolen device protection. This is off by default. I would recommend turning it on. Once we turn on stolen device protection, it might not seem like anything has happened, but if you ever want to go turn it off, you'll have to wait a certain amount of time and authenticate with your Face ID. Once stolen device protection is on, certain things will be inaccessible without your Face ID. There won't be any passcode fallback. I'll put this link to the Macrumors article, but this includes things like passkeys or passwords saved to your iCloud keychain, applying for a new Apple card, erasing your iPhone, or using saved payment methods in Safari. And if you want to change any of these things, like your Apple ID password or other security settings, you will be required to wait an entire hour before you can change those settings. This way, if someone did have your physical iPhone and knew your passcode, they wouldn't be able to disable Find My or erase your iPhone, and that gives you 60 minutes to get to a computer, a web browser, or one of your other Apple devices and lock this device or remote wipe it so they can't get access to your sensitive information. Feature number 4 is AirPlay in hotels. Now this feature might take a while to roll out to hotels across the world, but next time you go into a hotel that supports AirPlay to the TV, you won't have to bring an HDMI cable or other device just to play your content on the TV in your hotel room. You should be able to AirPlay from your Apple devices over the hotel Wi-Fi to the TV set with nothing else. Hilton has said their chain of hotels will support this feature, and hopefully we see this pretty much everywhere. I don't want to bring an HDMI cable anymore. And this isn't brand new to 17.3, but I missed this the first time around. If you go back to the Settings app, go to General, and then AirPlay and Handoff, you'll see at the bottom there's the option to be an AirPlay receiver, meaning this phone or your iPad can be a destination for another device to AirPlay to. And you can see in the little fine print, this is going to be specifically for Apple Vision Pro. As I film this, Apple Vision Pro is still not out, although I've pre-ordered it, so I'll be doing lots of testing, but it's unclear whether you'll be able to do an HDMI out, be able to record the video feed in the headset on some other device, but you will be able to AirPlay what you're seeing in the headset to another device, be it a Mac, iPhone, or other iPad. So if you really want to record what's being seen, you can probably do some kind of screen grab or screen recording with this AirPlay feature enabled. And finally, in iOS 17.3, we have a new wallpaper. If you go to Settings and then Wallpaper, you can choose to add a new one, and you'll see the new Black Unity wallpaper that comes in multiple styles. Here's the multicolor, kind of a red, green, space gray maybe. I do really like the design of this year's wallpapers. I'm kind of a green guy, so I might go with this. But this will be available here on your phone, and also you get an Apple Watch face with this wallpaper as well. There's supposedly other bug fixes in iOS 17.3. Fortunately, we haven't seen a lot of additions to shortcuts. Would love some new actions here. But also stay tuned because new shortcuts videos are coming to the channel very soon. There was actually one just this past weekend. More shortcut suggestions from you, and they were pretty advanced, using a third-party app like Pushcuts to be able to send notifications for smart home devices. I did some toggling shortcuts and triggering shortcuts with NFC tags. That's pretty fun. If you want to check that video out, I'll put it right up here and the links down in the description. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Future updates to iOS, iPadOS, watchOS, all the things I cover right here. Also new shortcuts, smart home, and yes, Apple Vision Pro, once I get my hands on it, we'll be doing multiple videos on that. If you have specific questions about the headset, leave them down in the comments. I'm hopefully going to figure out what to use it for, what's a regular use case, either in work or entertainment, but I'm really excited to try it. And I'll put another video right here that YouTube thinks you'll really enjoy. Hit that like button before you go. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.